Hello there, everybody. Oimon here, and welcome back to Fallout New Vegas. And I will say, I'm actually kind of lucky I'm putting this out on time. Okay, so on top of having a pretty rough night's sleep last night, although that's par for the course for me, combined with having to go uptown and do shit today, I'm pretty wrecked. I'm a little out of it. This may not be a full three-hour stream. We'll see how it goes. I was playing some Stellaris, which is a game I enjoy playing, even though I'm really fucking terrible at it. I have considered actually doing a stream series with Stellaris, like, in the hope that perhaps some people will come in and tell me what the hell I'm doing wrong, because I know Stellaris is quite a popular game. So I don't know, I'll think on that one. Here's the thing, I love playing Stellaris with cheats. I know that's like sounds really, really bad, but there's something fun about just taking all the other AI empires out of the place. And then, you know, giving you free reign of the entire galaxy to just explore, have fun, and see what weird stuff you can do. And technically speaking, that's not a cheat. You just have to change one line of code in a file somewhere. So that's pretty good fun, actually. I quite enjoy that. But, you know, if I did play Stellaris on stream, I'd play it legit, you know, with AI empires and everything. Because, yeah, I mean, I like Stellaris. It's a good game. But as I said, I'm fucking awful at it. Which is actually true of a lot of real-time strategies. I love a good strategy game. Real-time, turn-based, whatever. I'm just terrible at them. But I still love them. I still enjoy playing them. So anyway, that's neither here nor there. So yeah, I was playing Stellaris. And of course, normally what I do is I start streaming at 3. And so usually about an hour beforehand, or just like a little before 2 o'clock, I'll stop whatever I'm doing, I'll go to Twitter, I'll prepare a tweet for sort of, you know, I'm streaming in an hour's time kind of thing. And then it'll be like, you know, then I'll go get myself some lunch, some food, you know, just something to keep me going during the stream period. I'll eat that, then I'll start setting up, like, you know, my second screen, so it's got all the stuff I need on it. I'll start the game, I'll get OBS running, you know, I'll change all the information on Twitch to match. A lot of stuff that you do, because, you know, streaming takes a lot of prep. You can't just die, well, you could, but it wouldn't look very good. So, yeah, it takes a lot of prep and stuff like that, but, you know, that, and that usually takes me about 10, 15 minutes, depending on how distracted I am at the time. But I had to rush through all of that, because at 20 past 2... I noticed what the time was, because I was too busy playing Stellaris to notice, which is entirely my fault. So I was almost late, and considering how tired I'm feeling, I was actually close to calling it off. I was like, no, we can at very least finish Dead Money, and I do have one more thing planned for today, which should be quite good, should be quite fun. So yes, we need to keep going, because I'm not just going to stop Dead Money just because I'm feeling a bit tired, because we saved God and Dog, and they don't remember me now, which is sad. And so next up, we need to go to the theater. We need to go to see Dean, and we need to hopefully, you know, hopefully he's nice, he's good, and he likes me. We'll see what happens on that front. And then once we're done with that, of course, we have a lot of other things to do. You know, we got to deal with Elijah. And save, what is her actual name? I forget. Nope, it's gone. Anyway, she'll tell me when I get there. So yeah, we've got that to do. So we've got to finish off Dead Money. That should take me an hour, maybe hour and a half, depending on how certain things go. You know, running from the security holograms is a bit annoying during that one section, but it's not too bad. So aside from that, that's fine. Obviously then we'll do a bit of a sort of a post DLC run through the area, make sure I've got absolutely everything. Because I know I found all the Dean stashes, so I got that. That's quite nice. Make sure I've got all the prototypes and stuff for the thingamabobby majiggy. And yeah, in general, Just make sure I'm keeping on track of everything. So, yeah, that's the plan. And once we get back to the Mojave, I do have something in mind to do for the rest of the stream. So we'll see. If we'll see how I'm feeling at the 2-hour mark. If I'm feeling particularly out of it, I'll stop there. I should be able to keep going. Anyway, we've got to go deal with Dean. And hear his fateful story. Hopefully. If it loads. Yes. Okay.
If that ghoul's still alive, correct that. Or break him.
Okay, right. Nothing there. Sierra Madre chips, pre-war money, nice. Bob pins. Ooh, easy lock, I can do this. Hoisting. No. Mission, CDS, and the eye, could be that. Great! Mission complete. Yada yada yada. Security code. Okay, so we got the security code. That's a start. That's something at least. Oh dear, I think they're dead. Front desk password. I don't need that. Thanks, I'd already done it. But still, nice to know you're thinking of me. Or thinking of those who perhaps don't have... Ah, yes. Ooh, hang on. Do I have the right gun equipped? There it is. Alright. That's right, some of them are red. Hang on. Alright. More or less get away from that one by standing in the middle. The red one over there. There is partitures. Ooh, key. Nice.
Finally, a friendly face. Hey, partner, up here. They're in a bit of a predicament here. Had to duck backstage, take a powder. The audience is a little murderous tonight.
Mm. How'd you get up there?
No idea. Woke up here, thought I was dreaming for a second. Right back on the stage, the mic. Thought I was back at the Fronds. Except no audience used to pack theaters back then. So, stepped up on stage, checked things out. Then suddenly, holograms walked out of the wings. They started raising their hands to their heads, all creepy-like. Not a good sign.
Well, holograms, what are you talking about?
Look, those ghosts are going to come out of the wings behind you in a second. The security types, not the friendly, bald types.
Oh dear.
And if you got in here, the door's probably locked tight behind you, so don't back up or run for the exit. You're not going to make it.
Oh dear.
Trust me, as soon as you can, run to the door to the left. Use the key you got out of the music rag there and camp out. As bad as things are, it's going to get a lot worse if either of us pops. So get backstage. Until we get a better plan.
Wait, I need to head the door to your left or my left?
What? Oh, my left. Your right. So, yeah, run to the door on your right. Almost got you killed there. Us killed there.
Leave me a little more to go on if we're going to break us out of here.
Right. Let's see. When you get the door open, there'll be an exit door dead ahead. Don't take it. It's most likely filled with toxins from the vents, so hug the wall. Make as much space between you and the door, or it's cloud nine in a casket. Past that is my dressing room. Under the table there's a footlocker. It's tucked back a bit, so you might miss it. Inside, a gun, some ammo. Not much help against the ghosts. Still, if you're about to give up, call it quits. Throw it to me so I can eat a bullet first.
Charming. These theater speakers are wired to a central sound system, right?
Yeah. Yeah, so what? We got bigger problems with the holograms. No, no, wait. You're right. The theater piped music and sound backstage, which means those little squealers are in the corridors back there, too.
Calm down. Think. Do you know specifically where?
Let's see. Once you break right, watch each turn in the corridor. One will be on your right, past my dressing room, and up. My dressing room. May have left the radio on, right by the table. If you could just shut it off instead of blowing it out. Never mind. And there was a speaker in the prop room, too, on the wall between the entrances. And, well, walk slow. There's bound to be more.
Mm-hmm. That's the radio speaker system. What about the central sound system?
The speakers are all controlled by a central console. It's the farthest from the only door out of here, so you'd need to do a full circuit of the corridor to get to it. Once there, you'll need to shut it down, and I don't have the code. If you have the code, you can turn off all the speakers. Make them settle down. Getting backstage should buy us time. Just take it slow.
All right, getting backstage is a temporary measure if I can't find the security terminal.
Yeah, right. So, let's see. Security's here because the show hasn't started. Guests aren't allowed in, so guess we need to start the show. Okay, so when they were setting this place up, and Sinclair even set up hologram recordings of the shows so we could watch and critique our performances before a fake audience. Whatever. Thing is, when the recording queued up, a nice, calm, appreciative audience appeared in the theater.
Mm.
So find the music, get it to the projector room upstairs, then play it.
All right, makes sense. Any idea where the music is?
The holotape should be where I left it. No, wait. It's in Vera's dressing room, probably. Anyway, snag the key out of my room and look around Vera's room. The holotape has to be there. Well, sometimes Vera used to watch from the projection booth, so she must have had a master key.
All right. What are you doing with the key to her room?
Do I have to spell it out? Come on.
This casino security system is pissing me off.
You are preaching to the choir. Sinclair and his security, don't even get me started. Look, just...
All right, we break right. Fortunately, and here come the security guys. Not good. All right, so we're in. Any of the ones wrong side of the door. I feel like woo! Hello. I don't think they like that very much. Yep, they're still there. Alright, Bobby Pin Chip.
It's a little small. And hey, what's the hands in there? Remember where I left everything.
Hot box, some hot box safe. That's a shame. There is backdoor stage key. Ooh, ammo, I'll take some of that. Do I have a locksmith? I don't remember. I do. Do I want to crack the safe? Okay, well, we'll have a look around, see if there's anything else I can get first, because if there's more than one thing. Alright, we're off to a good start. relatively so anyway. Door outside, don't want that. Because I think, there we go.
Maybe I can shut down these ghosts using the stage manager's old terminal.
Well, it was a point for effort, I guess. At least we know he's gonna live, because he called me partner at the start. That's the thing, if you treat him nice enough during, like, the first time you meet him, then... Careful now. Don't go blowing up. There we go. Ah, much better. Now I can explore her room and find that key that she apparently hid somewhere. That's hard locked too, huh? Interesting. Ah! Pin. Meeting people. Nice. Not that one, huh? More of the... hologram projectors. So the thing is, we need to get up there and get up to there, I think. Memory serves. Took care of one of them at least. And we've stopped the beeping, so that's good. Oops, more bobby pins. Oh, that's very easy. I can pop that. Hey, Jagoth. Quickly, run. Yeah. Some chivalry, take that. All right. Loud, it works for me. Like me. Something's gotta give. Did I miss a key
now,
or something?
Deal with the ghoul. This has gone on long enough.
Nice job. Good thing I was distracting them while you flicked them off. We're a good team. I run the show while you run the box office. Oh, those electric ghosts aren't the kind of audience I like at the best of times. At least the ones in the villa had manners. Don't even know how I ended up here. Guess the casino still recognizes guests, even after all this time, huh? How's that for history?
Yeah, lucky us. Love getting shot at by pre-war ghosts.
Look, I'm more about the short goodbyes than long thankful speeches. But I appreciate you bailing me out of a tight spot there, partner. I know you didn't do it out of the goodness of your heart. So let me give you something a little more practical. A way we both come out ahead.
What do you mean?
I'm not an idiot. I know the reason I'm in here now is because of the old guy. And you. And you're wearing a collar. So I trust you a little more than the old guy. He's more controlling than I'd like.
Thing is, here's where being my partner pays off. See, I know how to get into the casino vault.
Ooh. What do you mean?
There's a private elevator, Sinclair's elevator. It's up in the executive suites in Vera's room. Not a coincidence. Vera. She was my other partner before the bomb. Took some legwork. Some convincing made it happen.
How so?
Sinclair was already puppy-eyed, so all I had to do was the introductions. She smiled, fluttered her eyes, showed a little leg, and he built this whole place for her. Made her the key to his vault, like a joke, because of her name. Her fake Hollywood name. Except Sinclair didn't know I'd been there first. I could twist her whatever direction I wanted.
Mm. Mm.
All she had to do was get inside the Sierra Madre for the gala, then use her voice to open the door. After that, smooth sailing. Would have been the biggest heist in history. Sinclair left holding the bag. Ruined.
So what happened?
The bomb. Vera got sealed in here. A few hundred years go by, give or take. Almost the end of the story. Then you came along. Now we finish the job. Rob the Sierra Madre, rip out its heart. Last chapter of Frederick Sinclair. Close the book.
What's your problem with Sinclair?
Problem? All high and mighty. Lording it over everyone. Acting so self-righteous, like nothing could touch him. He was the one with the problem. Never got mad at anything, nothing seemed to shake him. Even after his life kept getting dragged through the dirt. Always kept looking for the bright, shining future in everything. So, I decided to take everything from him.
What did he do to you?
Do to me? What, weren't you listening? He thought he was better than me. Don't believe me? Look around. This big casino. This big, colossal monument. Think it was for some woman? No. All ego. All self-righteous in lights. Fit him perfect. Had to take him down a few pegs. Bring him down to my level. Begin again? Some things you don't get up from. I was going to prove it.
So you're going to prove it now? How?
I didn't know at first. Then the old man showed up. You showed up. Then that woman showed up, covered in scars. The one who makes all the hand signs, a little tight around the corners of her mouth. I put her in the clinic, tuned her like an instrument. If she heals up, it's not going to be her voice speaking anymore. That is, if the Sierra Madre didn't get her. If it did, well, there's enough of Vera around for me to spend a few years piecing a book together.
And if she's alive?
Then she can make some beautiful music. I'm not banking on it. So here's the short of it. Piece together Little Miss Vera Key's song in the right order. Sierra Madre opens its legs, we're in business.
Head out, see what I can
do. Go! Knock yourself out! I'm just going to catch my breath a bit. That performance, well, more pressure than I was expecting.
Woo! Thank you. Trigger of experience from that. Nice. All right. Reinforced helmet. How's my one doing? I'll take it. Oh. Oh well. You couldn't have like broken this before, you idiot. Screw it. Alright, so I think that's everything. I did get a flying congressional stuff. And I think that's the only one. Oh, I forgot to get me a list up. Hold that thought. Video suite, Sierra Madre Casino. Lion Congressional Style. There we go. Huh. Want to play some Caravan? No. No. No one wants to play Caravan. It's annoying. It's a stupid mini game. And I hated that you had to play 30 games for it for a fucking achievement. It was a bloody
another
achievement.
Another frame. Good. Almost have the entirety of what I need from the music archives. Once you have the last fragment, you can thread the archives together at the main floor terminal.
I did remember. Better. I did realize on the after the fact that I actually forgot a couple of skill books over here. So just bear with me one moment. Alright. Hi. Probably my fault because I wasn't paying attention close enough. Okay, so it's just the third floor office. Great, Tumblr's today. Oh, that reminds me, I didn't get the, damn it, now I gotta go back and do that, too. Tumblr's today. That would be under D. 4 points of lockpicking. Alright, and the other one I forgot was in that cashier's area. Which is... I don't remember. I don't actually remember how the hell you get to the cashier's area. Oh, that apparently, but I need a key. Does anybody remember where the key for that door is? Because I don't. I feel like it should be kicking around in one of these offices somewhere. Guess not. Well, I do know an alternate way in there. It's just a little inconvenient, and I'm not 100% sure if I'm going to get myself stuck. But let's see what we can do. Nope. Damn it, didn't jump. I'm in. Acrobatics, I'm in. Ooh, there it is. One cashier's key. Ah. Huh. Not bad nothing, I guess. How much you trip? Okay, it's just going to be right behind the desk. Behind the desk. Ah! Found it. I don't think you can pickpocket the holograms. Can you? I didn't think you could. Alright, let's see if I can break into this. Remained. Ooh. Yay. That'll do me. Alright, so that's the skill books I missed. That was my fault, because I was... When I was playing this last week, I was sort of trying to rush to get it all done in time, but it ended up running out of time anyways. What you gonna do? Oh dear, I think he broke. Also, I forgot. There was a couple of safes. Alright, locksmith reader, do it. Oh, I didn't need to do that. Damn it, is it the master key for everything? If so, I'm just going to reload the save because I'm not going to waste a locksmith reader if I've already got the key for something. Yep, god damn it. Hang on. I'm not wasting that. I didn't realize the master key worked on those two. Although in retrospect, that actually does kind of make some kind of sense. That's good. That's very good. Good, that actually saves me a skill magazine. I just saw the lights flicker. If I suddenly vanish, then the power went out, which would be a bit annoying. Just mental note to keep making regular quick saves. I am getting rid of that. There we go. All right, let's go deal with the executive. Sweet. I need to go back and open up the safe in the cashier's office. We'll see. I'm not that fussed about the one in the cashier's office because I may need it for a place around here.
Find the mutant, deal with her. She's
so we'll see.
On this floor. Floor is buzzing with the emitter signatures. What? Total holograms.
If it's who I think it is. This is Christine, so far to be here. Recovered, no. In what looks like an old-world hotel room. Please. Like glass. Two rooms. Exit sealed. All doors are locked down. Security's activated. And emitter signals are lighting up all over this floor. I'll do what I can from here. Floor's got holographic security. Not latest tech. Field of view targeting systems. Primitive. Familiar.
Claire, where did you go? Why did you leave me here? Why? Sinclair! Sinclair! I die here, amongst the ghosts.
Because it's actually kind of...
I'm still being recorded by the hall.
See, look, there you go, another 75 lock right there. Hello. Because you just listen to these holograms that are on repeat of, like, Vera's... I'm assuming last words.
Please. Let me leave. We all pay for what we've done. I'm so sorry, Sinclair. Sorry, I
need to remember where.
I should have trusted you. Go. Go. Sinclair?
And here comes the rain. Perfect timing. Probably. Beep, 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 beep. How many cigarettes, so little time. Shush. Alright. Now where were the things here? Executive suites. Bookshelf in Vera's room. That's fine. So we gotta get there first. That's the easy part. Ooh, another one there. Oh, a locksmith. Ah, two locksmith readers. That's good. That means now I can pop both of those locks without having to worry about it too much. Bobby pin. Oh, and fixing things. And an easy to access maintenance tool. That's experience. Hanging. Ooh, yay. Gone quite lucky with those. Stable hallway loudspeakers, yes. Download. Status report. All right. bobby pin. Much in there, anything here? There's your door seal. Lock the door. Oops, sweet maintenance key, that'll come in handy. Keyed. That's where we came in.
Sinclair, I'm trapped. Please. Oh god, the security systems won't let me out. They're keeping me here. I'm going to die here. Amongst the ghosts. I'm still being recorded by the holographic system. No. I came so far to.
I can do this. Come on. Crucible! Nope. Okay! Nope. Corridor, maybe? Also, damn it. Scroll back up. Missiles. By simple process of elimination. Yeah, and I realized there are only four answers left because I was looking at it normally and I was like, actually. Sometimes you find emitters hiding behind doors.
Security systems won't let me out. They're keeping me here. I'm going to die here amongst the ghosts.
See, that's another hard lock.
I'm still being recorded by the holographic system.
Off. I don't have to listen to your wailing over and over again. As fun as it is. Listen to a woman screaming for her life about being just left behind and in a completely empty hotel, abandoned. Yeah, that's what you want to listen to. All right. emitters. So many chips. Chips. I'll probably end up having chips for dinner tonight. Ooh. Shush. I believe the plan is steak and chips, so it'll be very lovely for dinner. I love a bit of steak. Big sweet room, so that's where we'll go last. I don't need one of those right now, but I will take that. Because why the hell not? A lot of redundancy in things like this, which is obviously done very deliberately. Much better. Oop. Door locked. Lots of chips. I forget, do we have to cash in all these chips before we leave, or can we? No, there's a thing in the bunker back at back in the Mojave that does it, didn't they? I like how they're just random piece of metal armor. Which does imply that someone else made it this far at one point, because why would somebody in the hotel just have metal armor? Unless there's a really weird story there. Jumped over the lazy paladin. So I think that's everything, although I can't hear something. Ooh. Well, that worked. The box is empty. Pretty much. You let it go. What are you? Crap. You know, I'm genuinely shocked that I've still got inventory space. I figured I would have run out by now. Yeah, we've been in there. I think that's the whole lot. This is a bit maze-like, but it's not that big. Honey, I'm home. Where the vault is, I'm pretty sure. Where? Oh, there it is. Big Book of Science. I was literally just about to say, where's that skill book? I was like, I'll get it in a minute. But no, I already found
it. You made it. Good. First to talk. I'll keep this quick in case my voice goes out.
Is that like the woman in the Sierra Madre forecasts?
Do I? It sounds off to my ears. Hard to tell. Not to mention it hurts like hell to swallow. Might be why I got moved off to this suite. It's hers. That's her over there. Got trapped by security like I did. Just took a different way out.
Now that your voice is back, what did you want to say?
I've been hunting the one who hijacked your Pip-Boy, Elijah, for some time. He cannot leave the Sierra Madre alive. What he's done? What he's done here is nothing compared to what he's done in the past. The only way to bring him out is if you get to the vault. He won't allow you to go down there alone. That's when we kill him.
How long have you been hunting him?
Too long. Thought I might have had a chance to settle it before this event happened. But then the chance slipped away again.
Settle it? You're here to kill him?
Those are my orders. I've seen what he's done, and I believe in those orders.
Sounds personal.
He cut me off from someone I cared about a long time ago. He used his status to break us apart. So I had to find a new purpose. Same banner. Then he became unstable. Left a trail of crimes across the wasteland. Once word reached us, I was ordered to kill him.
Ooh, a whole sad story. He said he knew you.
He saw me, before the scars, at a place far from here. It's where he found some of the technology he uses now. It's a place called the Big Empty. The name's deceptive, if you know where to look. Almost got trapped there. There was someone else, though, who came along. Knew about Elijah.
Knew Elijah? How?
No idea. A courier. Wore an old world flag on his back. He was the one who pulled me out there. Told me where Elijah had gone. Helped me heal up. Listened to my story. He sympathized.
Sympathized? Why?
He said he understood what it meant to track someone who had such a impact on his past life. He said people were like couriers, sometimes never understanding the messages they brought. That's who he was hunting for. Some courier.
Ooh. Ooh. Funny thing. It's... I love the way they set it up. Because it's like, the DLC was almost like a season 2 kind of thing. Because they were 4 individual separate stories, but with this thread of Ulysses woven throughout them. You know, you hear, like in this one, and then in Honest Heart, you hear little previews, and then you finally hear him in the third one when you finally get to Big Mountain yourself. And then, of course, you actually meet him in the fourth one. It's so well set up. Like, it really makes you interested. I remember the first time I saw this, and it was like, it was dropping these hints, and it was like, oh, it's a courier, and he's looking for another courier, and it's obviously you. Like, they don't make any sort of surprises about that, you know. So it's really, really interesting, and I love the way they set it up. It's a really fun way to do it, and it keeps you really interested in wanting to know where the story goes. So, you know, even though the Honest Hearts DLC is pretty boring, I mean, it's nothing wrong with it, I just find it kind of bland. You know, the fact that you're going to get these little nuggets just sprinkled throughout. Anyway, could have said something sooner.
Wasn't sure until now I could trust you. Now I know. Look, when I woke up here, however that happened, I had this key on me. I think it belongs to her. Haven't had a chance to use it yet. Might open the dresser or the safe. Didn't have time to experiment with it before you arrived. Here you go.
How'd you get here from the Gala event?
The gala went off. The switching station opened up. Thought the screeching in the auto dock was bad. Station worse. Got outside, saw the light show, and it was enough to make me run to the casino. Also, it seemed like the lights and speakers were helping to guide me. Guess your master wanted a backup in case you died. As for being assigned to this floor, maybe it's because of my new voice. Your guess is as good as mine. Maybe it recognized me as a guest.
Just based on your voice seems unlikely. You were unconscious. Is there a chance he'll see reason?
Try and reason with him. See what happens. He's so lost in his technology. I don't think he even understands why anymore.
Does that auto dock there work?
Yeah, it's still functional. A lot of garbage data on it. Its basic procedures should still work fine.
Anything you can download off?
I can see. Check the route. Recent diagnostics. A lot of Med-X was dispensed for Vera Keys. Guess that's her corpse there for certain. And why all those meds are scattered around in here. Here's the medical report. Looks like she had some sort of terminal condition. Diagnosis isn't conclusive. must have been painful. I'm not even sure she knew if these medical reports are enough. She must have been numb most of the time.
Blimey. Okay. You know, Ducky, your scars?
No. They run a lot deeper than that. While I was hunting Elijah in the Big Empty, he trapped me in one of those medical research centers buried there. It did something to my head, and I got off lucky. It's difficult enough to read now, and somehow the leap between what's in my head and words, it just ends up being a mishmash of symbols, not letters. I can still do math, formulas, equations, writing poetry's out.
Said you got off lucky?
Yeah. I saw records of other patients and what had been done to them. Some couldn't hear anything but static. Others just gibbering wrecks. Never going back. And Elijah was on his way here, so I couldn't stop to see if it was something I could fix. If you can even fix what happened to me when they jabbed the electrodes into my skull and turned my head into a flashlight. Then I got here, and my voice got severed. Now I have a new one. Another thing Elijah has to answer for. All right.
Oop, jumping around there. Was that it? Hang on. Okay, glad you're safe. Hold up here, and I'll take care of Elijah.
Good luck. He's...
Fine card. Definitely take a super stim pack. Hello, Vera. Yes, please. I always like meeting people because they like to use speech quite a lot. Addition.
Can't believe it. I came all this way to have my voice stolen.
So it makes you wonder what she would have sounded like before her voice has changed, but you get to hear that. Although I don't know if it was like a mistake or something, but I'm pretty sure she's got the same voice if you go to the past recording of her in although that might have been done because of like ease of understanding who she was, you know. I don't know, I'm not sure. And then again, my memory could just be really flaky.
Would you stop? Such a kidder. This is Vera Keys auditioning for Love Sets Sail. God, this script. Don't get me wrong, I'm happy to have the Is that a plane overhead? Those bombers are nothing but big hornets buzzing around the sky these days. Is it gone? Alright. This is Vera Keys auditioning for Love Set Sail. Malcolm, ever since our freighter went down, I feel like my heart's fallen to the bottom of the ocean, along with my... Along with my career. God. Alright.
Okay, well, now that's sorry. Thank you to John Back One.
You have the last ride.
Just
that's
John,
all
I think.
Need.
Ooh, hello. Now, thank you for the follow. Thank you very much.
Go to the main lobby terminal. Thread the music sequence together.
Always appreciate the follow. This one I've had for a while, actually. Seems to have just gone slightly quieter than recently. But that's fine. Thank you. I do very much appreciate it. Hello. Ah, so close to hitting the next level. Oh, well, looks like that'll have to be Elijah. Alright. Music! Ah. Got it. All right. Well, not much else left to do except confronting Elijah. And then robbing the place of every single gold bar this place has got. Always do enjoy doing that. Anything else to drop off in here? Nice. Now, hang on. Memory serves. Alright, so I got that one. Alright, so there is a skill book in the actual vault area itself. That's nice. Okay, that's good, that's good, that's good. And second. Yeah, very good. Alright. Actually, I just realized it's 4 o'clock, and that means it's time for an ad break. So we shall be going down to the... Wait, we need to talk to her? Oh, fine. Well, in that case, we'll be... We'll be talking with her in just a moment. So we're just going to take a quick 3-minute ad break, and we shall be back in just a few minutes.
Cigarettes.
And we're back. Ooh, hang on. Put the microphone back in the right place. That might help. Hello, apparently I need to talk
to you. You're back. You sure you still want me here? Callers and all? Not much for waiting around with a bomb around my neck.
And the phrase for the elevator's audio lock.
You did. Looks like even the old world can't keep you out when you've got a mind to get in.
Mm-hmm.
So, I just rasp out some words and the vault opens. That woman, the starlet, she didn't build this place. Why would the builder do that?
This place, I'm not sure. It doesn't feel like a casino. Not entirely.
I know. The sealed doors, the security, it's almost a fortress. Think that's why we're being ordered to come here and crack it open?
I guess it's the object of someone's obsession or affection.
Love makes people do strange things. I won't argue that. It can drive you crazy sometimes if you can't connect. If they loved each other and they were together, I suppose that's all that mattered. But she's in that side room, dead, because the casino wouldn't let her leave. And who knows where he is?
I have no idea. Let's unlock it. Phrase contained in the lyrics to the song.
All right. If you go down there, are you prepared? What if you don't come back?
I've got you to come down after me. He'll respond to your voice.
I just wanted to make sure you're ready. When you go down there, that may be it for us. We won't be needed anymore. The one who made these collars, he'll follow you down there. And he won't let you leave. He's not one for sharing. Never was.
Ah. Don't have high enough perception for that. He'll come here to the suites. When he does, just let him go through.
I can't let him leave here. Look, you've done so much, and he's not going to show himself until you go down there.
Do you trust me? If you do, let go of this.
I can't let go. Every time I've thought about it, I've lost him so many times. He needs to die. What happened here with us? He's done so much worse.
Then go to the streets, follow me. If he escapes, you'll still be here. Wait.
You have to promise me. Promise me you'll deal with
him. Oh, well, don't worry, I'll kill him.
If I see him, I...
Please, I got this. Let me deal with him.
All right, I'll... But I'll need to leave this floor. He'll pick up my collar and...
Don't tell me where you're going. I'll find you after.
I... Never mind. Let me get the vault open. Begin again. But know when to let go. Sounds like you.
Open up.
Feels like the cloud crawled in my mouth and died. Begin again. But know when to let go.
Alright. I'm gonna make a quick save before we do this, just in case I've somehow managed to balls it all up. Yeah. was going to save all the companions. I want the good ending. Woo, I leveled up. Alright, need to get to... Whoop, there we go. Level 28. Excellent. Got that. We need... Mathrath. Yay! That's a good one. AP down. Always good. I'm gonna need it for Elijah. And there's the gold. Yep, here be a vault. Fun stuff. I'm pretty sure that bag is where the skill book is. Which is really annoying to get to. Unfortunately, we gotta go the long way. Hello to, hang on, Corn to, I'll call you Corny. Corny is fine. Hello. You've seen my channel. That's nice. That almost sounds like something a bot would say. Let's hope you're not a bot. Bots can be annoying, but hello regardless. I think he's a bot. Oh dear. So many bots, so little time. Alright, now where's the... Where is it? Over there. Worker's note. I'll read that later. Missed that. Hello. That doesn't sound good. That's a red one. That's unfortunate. Bloody beepers, honestly. Keep moving. Keep moving. Shit. Try that again. Can we hit the... blue one from here, or is it a little too... Well, we'll work out in the end. Only had to have my head exploded once. I don't know how there is a fresh apple just on the low. Crap. Alright, I guess it's this way first. Joe. Crap. Well, that ain't good. Ooh. Sure, turret password, why the hell not? I have no idea where I am or where the hell I'm going. In fact, I'm about to die. Ah, there. Yeah, made it. Woo! All right, I got it. Jumping in this game is so finicky, isn't it? Oh, hello. Hello, Grandpa. Can we turn you off? Okay, do that then. Hi. Fancy meeting you here. Oh dear. Go away. Go away. Bugger off. No. That's right. Bugger ye off. Gotta shut you guys off. Shut down alarms, that's a start. That's a decent enough start. Empty boxes. One of them. Now, where are the others? They're tiny little emitters. Like teeny tiny emitters. Hello, oh, there's one. Right. Okay. Good job, he's a bad shot. Damn straight. Go away. Where the heck is that third emitter? Gotta be somewhere. You bugger off. Can I get up? Come on. Yes, there it goes. Aha. Would be nice in the first place, but whatever. That's all three emitters gone. Now we don't have to worry about the damn holograms. Now all we need to do is remember how the hell we turn this off. Because I don't. Guess it wasn't that then. What it was. I don't remember. Oh. Yeah, that would probably work. Well, it's not like I gotta worry about money or anything. My ammo. Bad. Security shutdown. Dealing with Elijah soon enough. Turn the light back on actually, because, yeah. That's a bloody thing. I do need to remember. I know how you get down there. Attractive hot tape, that's nice. So I know you get down, I just don't remember exactly how you get back up. So, quick save and hold your breath. That'll do it. Can I get around? That works as well. Woo, made it. Alright, oh, I've got all this stuff to scratch off the list. Vera, if you're reading this, and I know what you and Dean have planned tonight on the eve of the gala, I love you very much. Whatever possessed you to choose Dean's arm over my hand is beyond me. Whether it was greed or lust, it led you here. Will forever keep us apart. I hope it leaves you as empty as it left me. As much as you sought what was inside the Sierra Madre, now it will keep you. The door has sealed, the elevator has left, and not even your voice will unlock it. The casino was my gift to you, and you will now be its heart for all time. Yeah, so the whole thing was basically a trap. Dean and Vera thought they were pulling one over on Sinclair, but Sinclair saw through the whole thing, and the whole point is that it was supposed to keep them here permanently. Yeah, that's sort of the sad story of the whole thing. Just betrayal and, you know, duplicity and greed and lust and blah 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 blah. Right. Now, a couple of things to work out. Now, if memory serves, here's the thing. I know I want to get all of the gold out of the vault, and this was something I talked about last week because I thought this was going to happen last week, but it didn't happen last week. It sort of, hang on, sorry, one sec. Just need to do something. Yeah. Obviously, I want to get all the gold out of this, and that requires, unfortunately, using a cheat to do. I mean, technically, there are legitimate ways to do it, but you're not supposed to be able to take it out. I'm trustworthy by entering the vault. So it's a case of... So the problem you've got, and the real big problem you've got, is that in order for me to be able to carry all this stuff up, I need to just give myself a whole bunch of carry capacity. The easiest way to do that is with the cheat. I want to say it's TGM, toggle god mode. But of course, if I do that, it means I can't fight Elijah legit, which I want to do. I want to be able to fight Elijah properly. But then if I fight Elijah properly, I may not have time to run all my way back around the place. Probably will, but anyway, I just made a save, so we'll see what happens here. Bobby pins. I mean, look at all this gold. Look at it. It's heavy. It's gold. I just really like taking out of it. I don't have any problem cheating just for this bit, because it's more of just a sort of side little oddity more than anything else. Sierra Madre armor, most definitely take that. Those. This I can deal with at least. Oh, I already had two, huh? Oh, did I accidentally take? Oops. could have took a helmet. Yeah. Apparently I have two Vera's outfits. Whatever. Gee, look at my weight. It's insanely high right now. But that's locked. That's a shame. Money. Anything else? There's a doctor's bag over here. That's quite nice. But what I can do actually is if I open this up. I think it's under MISC. If I go pull those off, just to go above, right into there. Hopefully that'll work. Go over here. Get rid of my cans of cigarettes that I picked up. Gold bar, because of course there is. Forgot about that one. Again, drop that off. Maybe I can fight Elijah legit and then just go to here really, really, really quickly and just grab it all at once. I don't think there are any more hidden gold bars anywhere. I think it's just a 37. Alright. Bolt control terminal. Vera keys. Live is extracted, file not found. Vera to Vera. Vera, if you're reading this, my fears have come to pass, and this is an apology. I hope you realize that what my last words meant to you. If so, they have led you here, and this place will keep you safe. I know what they meant for me, and I fear they have trapped me here. I have extracted the previous entry after our conversation tonight, and it can't have been easy for you, and I am sorry for all I've put you through in silence. I know while you do not love me, you did not mean any malice in what you did. I knew about your plans to rob the casino with Dean before you told me. Hearing it from you didn't make it any easier. For what it's worth, I'm glad you told me yourself. And I understood the tapes he had in his possession. I do not think either one of you realized what your addiction stemmed from, however. And that is the tragedy in this. I suspected the world would not have believed you regardless. So I respect your desire to keep it from others. When first building this villa, this casino, I meant it for you. As the world seemed to race headlong towards war, it became part of my desire to protect you. The loans, the funding I poured into this casino's construction, I knew it would not matter when war came for us. It was my means of creating a shelter. Defense of the world was bombarded in radiation and bombs. When Dean revealed his plans inadvertently through our introduction, I realized what had happened and how I had been tricked. For a time, my thoughts were dark. I changed the casino vault from a shelter into a trap, as I knew the first one to enter would be Dean. He would die down here. It would have been by his own hand. I fear, however, that I overstepped myself. The only safe place in this casino is the vault. I have tried to rewrite the systems, changed the protocols, and I cannot. I will do one last check on the pipes by the edge of the outside platform and see if anything can be done. I fear it is useless. If you come down here, do not access any of my personal accounts entry. It contains only a message for Dean, and it will seal the door, and you will have no way out. Even the elevator is designed to automatically return when the door is closed, and it will lock in place. There should be enough in the vault to sustain you until help arrives. I've ensured that there is enough medical supplies down here to keep you comfortable. The hologram should defend the casino from any attackers, and the hologram beacon in the villa will broadcast an emergency signal so that others know you are here. When danger has passed, rescue will come. I hope you were able to read this and know that I loved you. Frederick Sinclair. That's the final little twist. Vera was being blackmailed by Dean. But remember that blackmail tape we listened to earlier? There was no blackmail material on it. The whole thing was a giant sham. Dean had her under his thumb for no reason whatsoever, so Vera played along. They tried to con Sinclair, but it didn't work. He saw right through it. In the end, his desire to protect Vera won out, and he tried to turn the vault from a trap into a place of safety. But it all fell apart because the bombs fell a day early. In fact, the bombs fell a day early for a lot of things. Sinclair's personal accounts. Nah, I don't think I need that. Hello, Elijah.
You're in the vault, finally. After all this time. The Sierra Madre. Mine. Don't move. Don't go into the vault, and don't touch anything else. There may be more traps down there. Another security system.
Still hiding behind images and screens, I see.
Hiding? Trapped. You think you were the first one to unlock the casino door? No, I did it. With other hands, other bodies. After that, the casino wouldn't let go. Once I was locked in, no way out. Until your Pip-Boy signal came to life in the villa. Then things changed. And here you are.
You got a lot to answer for.
Do I? For what? Your greed, curiosity. You came here on your own. No one held a gun to your head. I've seen your Pip-Boy archives, your map markers and notes. You picked up the Sierra Madre signal just as I did. You couldn't resist. So if you feel I have a lot to answer for, no. The blame isn't on my shoulders. Might as well have put the collar on yourself.
How did you access my Pip-Boy?
You speak as if your fingers have never touched the keys of a Robco terminal. No machine is foolproof. They are designed to obey us. The Pip-Boy's operating system has vulnerabilities. Advantages to those who've studied its construction. Even superficially. It's just a machine, though. Its real vulnerability is who wears it. And that's how you were caught.
What do you mean?
That thing on your wrist. It's a convenience. It tells you where to go, what to do. Dulls your brain. It may have helped you find the Sierra Madre broadcast, but it's just as much a crutch today as it was in the old world.
Is there any further questions? If you're not going to come down, if you're going to come down here, do it.
No. I'm not going to take the chance while I'm so close. Not this close. No. Not again. I can wait. Afford to be careful. You? You're locked down there. This is the only entrance. And I have free reign of the Sierra Madre. I have time. More than you. Besides, there might be more traps. I'll send more scouts in. Yes. Others. You're resourceful. Don't want to leave anything more to chance.
Unless you come down there, my truth in the vault, I only want to leave. Then I'll find a way to lock the secrets of the vault and take them for myself. I can't remember which one triggers in the best.
Then all you need to do is wait. Consider this punishment.
Oh, good. Oh, just one point. Wow, 1 point of speech low. You follow the signal too. You want what's down here, I want out. Let's deal.
That signal, that siren's call, lured me in, yes. And being trapped in the Sierra Madre, perhaps forever, that has made me more cautious. I have my freedom, access to the bottom of the casino, and you under my control. I can wait.
You're right, you have everything, except the vault.
If you seek to goad me, impatience and greed led you here, not me. It doesn't control me as it does you. I won't fall prey to another trap, either Sierra Madre or yours. There is no trust between us, and there will be no trades either.
Greed implies you want more than you deserve. You've earned this.
I have earned it. Fought for it. Paid for it in blood, mine, others, countless times.
I'm coming down. I'll meet you face to face at the vault entrance. No tricks. If you prove troublesome, well, there's always the collar.
Now I really want to kill him because he's got a brilliant weapon. His Gauss rifle is great. I need to be ready with something good. What's my best weapon? I suppose the automatic rifle will do quite nicely. Some ammo for it. Now I just need to wait here for him. I kill him, and then I go running for it. Once he is dead, then I can turn God mode on. I can run for it with the gold out of here. And once I get back to the Mojave, I can just drop it off at the Lucky 38, and we'll be good to go. Here he is. Coming in.
Huh? What's this? Alarms. What? You think you can run?
Groves and his gadget. Yes, fucking please. Alright, one second. Damn. Alright, now I gotta run for it. Everything's blowing up. Not exactly sure why killing him triggers everything. I think it's that EMP bomb he had on him, I can only assume. Ah! Oh dear, the beeping's getting faster. Go, 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 go. Almost out, almost out, almost out, almost out, almost out. Open. Bloody shields. Sonic doors. And that, as they say, is your loss. Heist of the centuries. Oh yeah. That's it. That's that, as they say, is it? That's the end. Excellent. Now, I can't remember if there's anything left that I haven't done. I'm trying to think, like, what things are there that I might have accidentally missed? Did I use that Nikola Tesla book? I didn't, there we go. And your weapon's up by 4. Okay, so we can mark that off. So that is... So I've done all the quests. In and of itself, that wasn't going to be a problem. There are no, like, optional side quests or anything like that. I got all the skill books, so that's really, really good. Obviously I'll be leaving here with the gold, so that's really good. Bomb colors off, so I don't have to worry about that crap anymore. In terms of collectibles, I know I picked up all of the Dean's stashes. I didn't get all the cards, but then I couldn't give a fuck about that shit. like, I so don't care about playing cards. So I'm not gonna go bother looking for those. I've got the Sierra Madre Reinforced Armor, I've got Elijah's robes, Vera's outfits, I can use the rebreather. No, I can't use the rebreather from using the helmet. I don't need the helmet for a moment. Like I said, the bomb collar is gone. That's pretty much everything. So, yeah. I don't... Okay. First time I've been there. I've been playing this game for bleeding ages, and that's the first time I've been there. So, yeah, I think... I legitimately think that that is indeed everything, you know? I think. I don't think I've missed anything. Unless anybody out there watching this can point to anything and say, yes, that's something you've missed. I honestly can't think of anything. What I will do is, because I can, I will make a save, and I can always sort of nip back. Well, no, not really, but, yeah, that was always one thing that always kind of annoyed me, that noise in the background. That. Like, it never stops. Now that the casino's open, that noise never stops. It's actually very annoying. I don't believe I missed anything there. I mean, technically, I suppose there's the... This stuff, these recipe books, but I think I've got all those. Let me just check real quick, because I can, because I've got it, you know, it's there, it's an option. Fallout New Vegas, Dead Money, here we go. I could do a bit of wandering for these just for a minute. Wouldn't do me any harm in the long run, I don't think. Because I can sort of cross them off the list that I've got. So I did miss one, actually. I missed the 308 round, the village police station. Police station. Get out of the... Let's pick these up, because then I can... If I take a bunch of the credit chip things with me, I can then use it to buy stuff. And I feel like... Actually, am I going the right way for the police station? I think I am, but... Yep, it's a police station. I'm going to ignore enemies as best I can. Because of the whole god mode thing. Which I suppose I could turn off, but yeah, what are you gonna do? Go away, please. I'm mostly thinking about the upgrades more than anything else, so we'll sort of see what happens. Now, it said in the male restroom, first floor, next to the toilet. Male restroom. Oh, yeah. It's hidden. Okay, so we got that one. That's good. Alright, what was the next one I missed? Gotta go find one there. Never mind. Look, I just want to get out of here. Let me go. Oh, hi. That's one of the things I find kind of annoying, that you can't leave this place once you... you can't return to this place once you leave. Which personally I find very annoying. Right, okay, so we've got... Oh, okay. Really? That's the medical district. Hold up. I need to get to there. Great, back the way I came. Of course it is. Because of course it is. find my way to Puesta del Sol South. Apparently it's the place where I left Dean? At least all the doors are unlocked, so that's not a problem. Oh good, they're all still dead. Hang on, I've missed the... Yeah, right. Sorry. Okay. So I gotta get back up to... Where's the roof? Up there. Don't need to worry about that. Technically, I'm a god. But then you all knew that anyway. Oh yeah, so it is. Apparently I'm blind. Well, that's nice. Careful now. Okay, where's a shop? Terminal place. Gotta be one somewhere. So we got a mod for the auto rifle, huh? No, just the one, thanks. Yeah, that's nice. Alright, there's also one for the bear trap. That's in Salida del Sol. So we got buff out. Demolition charge, yes. Matter of fact, there's two for demolition charge, but I only need one. Advanced calibration, yes. Focus optics, yes. Reinforced components. That's in the Puesta del Sol switching station, which is actually where I am. Sort of. Where's the switching station? That way. I love these wikis, you know, or the wikias, or whatever the hell you want to call them. They're great. The fact that you can just look up any information you need whenever you need to. Where the hell am I going? Round, apparently. That bloody brrrr sound is so annoying. Alright, switching station. Near elevator and remote maintenance terminal. Really, all the way back to the far end of the place. At least I don't have to worry about the tickety-tick-ticks. It's over there. Huh, all the stuff's been moved from here. That's good. Wait, what? Oh no, it hasn't. It just didn't load in. I was like, oh, there's no gas down there. No, there's gas down there. You just can't sodding see it. Yeah, I was thinking about it. I probably could have taken the elevator in, but never mind. No, wait, that's the wrong... What the wrong room? I thought that was where you had to... Oh, I must be thinking of the wrong sodding room. Ah, yes, now I remember. There it is. Ooh, careful now. Nope. Not the best game for jumping. Oh yeah. Cool. Okay, well that gets that. Never mind. Where am I? Where's the exit? Alright, that gives me the holding rifle reinforced components. You know, I had a feeling there was one I was missing. So, Make one of them. Add these mods to these weapons, actually. Alright, so we had the automatic rifle. Put the mod on. Increases weapon fire rate. Nice. And the hollow rifle. Add that in too. Sweet. Alright, so that's good. That's what we need. We do have the bear trap fist, heavy duty springs. That's in Salida del Sol. That's the other side. There's a few more left. Alright, so. Weapon repair kits, yes. Wine and vodka. Those are back in the casino. Super stim pack, yes. Stim packs themselves, yes. Steady, got that. Scotch again. Returns here, Madre armor. Oh, that's cut. To improve your clothing. Rebound is cut. Really? Radaway, Radex. Oh, we don't have the Radex one. Where's Radex? That's in Salida del Sol along with the bear trap thingamajiggy. That's cool. So it looks like we got all of them. No, wait, hang on. Radex. We don't have Mentats and we don't have Medex. Those are both in the clinic. How the hell did I miss that? I was thorough when I was exploring the clinic. I think. Where was the clinic? Medical district. Hi. I'm not even gonna bother with you. Alright, so we have two in the clinic, which is Medex and Mentats. Both on the second floor, apparently. Is there an easy way into the clinic? Guess not, we'll go around. Alright, so they're both on the second floor. I probably didn't finish exploring this place because of the robot, well, the holograms. Alright, so we got one in second floor computer terminal, second floor on bookshelf. Computer terminal? What, specifically on the computer terminal or like near a computer terminal? The bookshelf, didn't see that. Ooh. What's that? Dispenser codes. Ah, Medex, there it is. That's Medex. Just says second floor office on bookshelf. Of course, what qualifies as a bookshelf to someone may be completely different to what I think of as a bookshelf. Because this is a bookshelf, in my opinion. But they may consider these metal ones to be bookshelves. See it there. Oh, could be the one around here. Nope, that's the exit. Oh, hello. get knocked off at some point, perhaps? No, there's some wine. I can take that. I don't see it anywhere, which is weird. So we've got the medics, we just haven't got the mentats. According to the picture... It does have a picture. According to the picture, it's this one. I didn't have mentats, did I? I don't remember seeing it. Don't see it on the floor. The picture says it's this one, but I don't see it anywhere. Well, that's very strange. That is very, very, very strange. I don't understand it. It should be here, and it's not. And that's annoying. Which means either I picked it up, and for some reason the game just wasn't displaying it, or maybe it glitched out. You could have just, like, dropped out of the world, because... Bethesda games, guys. Bethesda games. Oh. Now I'm disappointed. Oh, well. Not much I can do about it, unfortunately. No, it's not going to be on the first floor. It said second floor. I checked the place. It's not there. I guess we'll just have to accept that I can't do that one. Hello. Ow. Missed. Missed. You shall never get me. Not when I'm just running away from you. Okay, so the only other two things I've got are in Salida del Sol, north and south, respectively. Or south and north, respectively, depending on which order of way around you're going then. Which is residential district? Straight ahead. Literally, straight. Hang on, let me just double check that real quick. Oh, it already is on Mentats. That was not there. Well, that explains that then. Couldn't get it because I already bloody had it. See, I told you that was an option. I said, odds are it's not there because I've already got it. Right, so this is south. Right, where is it? Switch room where you leave. Oh god, near some pipes. Really? Gotta get there first. I don't remember where it is, but I'm sure I'll find it soon enough. Where did you go? No, don't touch that. I want that. Now, where? Lost. I'm sure it was over this way. Okay, that's still got stuff in. Oh, maybe it was... Yeah, actually, now I remember. It was under here. There it is. Alright, so we're going to do this. Switch room and near some pipes on the right. Aha! God, they blend in well, don't they? And the other one is north. North, 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 north. This'll do it. Just while we're at it. cup of... I didn't, did I? Yeah. I can find one on a dead body. There's bound to be one kicking around here. So I thought I'd pick... I should have picked one up. If not, I'll just kill one. Alright, where are we? You're building up three stairs. Final floor is a terminal about workers. That helps. Kill the one I wanted. Take it. No, that's an alternate way out. I don't want to go that way. Where are you? There's at least several. Hang on. There's a ramp. There's a bookshelf. Bed. Is it? Oh yes, it is. Found it. Excellent. That's your lot. That's all of them. Now I can do that. I can put a mod on it. Ah. Excellent. Right, so that's all the stuff. Quite literally, that's everything. So now we can get the heck out of here. So, where's the quickest way to the exit? That's a good question. I don't know. Chunks. Now that's going forward. I'm going in the wrong direction. Here, didn't I? Hi. Hi. The cloud. Who was warning the internet would be a bad thing? Yep. Right. All right. So that's that. So I think yeah, that's all the stuff done. So that means we can head back, which means we can now use all of the recipes when we get back to the bunker, because, I've got all of them, which is nice. Congratulations. Oh, we should probably check. I got the wine and vodka ones. Unlikely to need them, but for the sake of a completionist feeling to it, should probably do that. Actually, no, what I should probably do is pause and take a quick 3-minute ad break, because it's 5 o'clock. Actually, it's 5 past, so technically I'm running a few minutes late. But it doesn't matter, that'll be fine. Okay, we're back. Right, so the only two things I'm missing, they're both in the casino. Which is fine. The casino should actually be technically working now. Yeah. You can actually better all your stuff. I think if you talk to this guy, change pre-war money for some Sierra Madre trips, can turn my Sierra Madre trips into pre-war money. That's all for now, thanks. Anyway, yeah, so that's not what we need. That's on the second floor. This is locked door, second level of the casino. I should first actually check which ones I'm missing, if any, really. Because you can only get it here. So there's the scotch, and there's the vodka. So in that case, I actually already got them. So that's good. Oh, there's also wine, which I've also already got. Yeah, you can only buy them in the casino, oddly enough. I don't even know if you can get it once you get back to the wasteland. Okay, so in that case, I already got all those. Great. I suppose the real question is, do I want to exchange all my my chips for pre-war money so I can then exchange that for actually useful caps when I get back home? How much have I got? Go under S, wouldn't it? Sierra 2,351. That'd be 235. I mean, I might as well. I don't really see any need for keeping the chips. Any time I save for pre-war money? 51 removed. Oh, actually, no, it was a 1-to-1. Whoa, that's gonna get me a lot of caps. Because I get like 7 caps for a pre-war money these days. Maybe even a little bit more now that I've upped my levels a bit. Actually, what is my level at? In terms of my stats. Oh, not bad. Wow, my barter is really high. That'll get me a bunch of money. Excellent. Okay. So my lowest is energy weapons at 61. And I haven't actually hit level 30 yet, so that's actually really good. Then again, I did go skillbook hunting at that one point, so... Yeah, okay, so that's actually really good. I think I'm about as set as I'm gonna be in terms of everything I've done, you know? Make another quick save, and then we'll go. Say goodbye to the red sky and the bright lights of the Sierra Madre. And goodbye to Vera. Let's end it.
The survivors of the Sierra Madre thought about gathering at the fountain and waiting for the courier. In the end, the caller's silence made them uneasy, and the fear of turning on each other made them hesitate and leave the goodbyes unspoken. The radio message at the fountain was enough for them, and there was no need to add another farewell on top of all they had suffered.
Dog forgot himself, as did the voice that raged within him. After their passing, a new voice spoke within the mutant shell. It was difficult for the voice to remember the two it once was. There was the beast, Dog, consumed by hunger. And the other, in reverse, the one consumed by control. Both were driven by need for the other. The courier brought them together somehow, joined the two into one. All that happened at the Sierra Madre was a faint memory to the new personality, like a flickering light in the clouds of the mind. The new voice did not think of the courier again until the battle at the Divide reached his ears. The battle between the two couriers, beneath the torn skies and the old world flag, each bearing a message for the other. And the mutant prayed the courier that had saved him had been saved in return.
Dean Domino, entertainer, singer, thief, explored the Sierra Madre not long after he was rescued by the courier. Once he left the theater, the Sierra Madre recognized him as a guest, and many doors opened to him. He had to admit it had been built to last. During his search, he came across the final records of Vera and Sinclair and realized what happened the night the bombs fell. He felt strangely sad for a moment, and he had no idea why. Shrugging it off, his mind turned instead to where the courier had come from. Vegas still survived, out there in the Mojave. Its sights, sounds, and casinos, ripe for the taking. So, giving the Sierra Madre one last nod and a wink, he set off beyond the cloud to begin again.
Christine, her mission complete. Found new purpose as the Sierra Madre's warden. She watched over it silently. By choice. Over time, the ghost people came to see her as one of the holograms. They would watch, silently, as she walked among them. At times, Christine thought of the courier, who had kept Elijah's hand from her throat. The courier reminded her of the other courier she had met in the Big Empty, and wondered if the two had found each other at last. She did not think of them again until she heard the legends of the Divide. The Divide, where the two messengers, the two couriers, fought beneath an ancient flag at the edge of the world.
You heard of the Sierra Madre Casino?
We all have. The legend, the curses.
Some foolishness about it lying in the middle of a city of dead.
A city of ghosts. Beneath a blood-red cloud.
A bright, shining monument, reaching out, luring treasure hunters to their doom. An illusion.
A promise that you can change your fortunes. Begin again.
Finding it, though. That's not the hard part. It's letting go.
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 Wait a moment. Before you go, we hope you've enjoyed your stay. Farewells can be a time of sadness. Letting go, difficult. As a guest of the Sierra Madre, you know that truth more than anyone. Frederick Sinclair believed one's life could be made anew every day. That fortunes were more than the wealth in your hands. Love. Life. Family. Those to care for. And those who will care for you. To those who know these joys, the Sierra Madre holds little they don't already have. Out in the world, beyond these walls, that is your chance to begin again. I hope you'll return in happier times. Until then, the Sierra Madre and I will hold you in our hearts. Wait a minute.
I really like that ending. It's sort of very melancholy, you know? Like, nobody waited to say goodbye to you. Probably for the best, thing as I was technically running around scavenging everything for about half an hour after that. But, yeah, I do quite like Dead Money. Jagoth is there saying good riddance, so that's fair. Don't worry, we're done with Dead Money. No more Dead Money, don't worry. It's done, it's over with. It's sad to see it go, but yeah, I mean, it's a very difficult DLC. Like, it's very brutal. Like, it takes everything away from you, and then, you know, it's like, it's really hard to deal with. But yeah, look, you can get all your stuff here if you really, really want to. Although, yeah, you can't get the alcohol for some reason. That's very strange. But, you know, if you're so inclined in doing that stuff, you know, if you brought any tokens back with you, but not necessary. Anyway, we need to pick up all my shit, which I think is in here. Oh no, never mind. Yeah, that's gonna take an age to finish up, and that dead body is still sitting there. So yes, we're finally done with Dead Money. It took a bloody age and a half, really, didn't it? So we'll lug this shit back to New Vegas. The game will almost certainly crash, because it always does, and hopefully it'll all be fine though. Okay. Strip. Go. Almost seems surreal being back here again, doesn't it? Because you go away for so long to do these DLCs. Because, like, with the exception of the last DLC, you are stuck in the DLC until you finish. And to be honest... Yeah. And to be honest, the fact that you can go back at any point during the last DLC is kind of the point of it. Because, oh dear. Yeah, it's gone. I think it's gone. I'm pretty sure it's gone. Yeah, it's gone. Yeah, it's gone. Christ's sake. Every sodding time. But yeah, I mean, the fact that you can go back, that you can turn around and just walk away, is kind of part of the story of the fourth DLC and the point that Ulysses tries to make. Because, you know, the Courier has history, unlike the Lone Wanderer. And in fact, quite a lot of the Fallout main characters, your character has history. Your character has a past. And it's a past that wasn't spent in, like, a box somewhere, you know? Because in Fallout 1, you play a Vault Dweller, somebody who lived their whole life inside the Vault. Or at least a good chunk of it. Certainly their adult life is in the Vault. Because, I mean, it does sort of depend on how old you make yourself, really. But because I know age is like a thing. Oh, that's right. Technically, I'm over-encumbered. It doesn't matter. I can walk my way up to the thing reasonably well, assuming it doesn't crash on me again. You know, in Fallout 1, you're just a person who's spent their whole life in a vault. In Fallout 2, you're a tribal villager who spent their whole life in a tribe and just never left the safety of the village. In Fallout 3, again, you lived your whole life growing up in a vault. I mean, okay, you were born outside of a vault, but by the time you hit, 1 year old, you were already in there. In Fallout 4, yes, you have your history, but it's almost exclusively pre-war. And then you were sealed inside the vault. And again, even in Fallout 76, you have spent most of your life inside the vault. Yes, you have a little pre-war history, but it doesn't come into play, even in 76. So Fallout New Vegas is the only time where your character has had an effect on the world before the game starts. Your character has a sodding history. And it's funny that that actually comes into play, you know, at some point. Okay, so, first things first, I'm going to drop off all of the gold in one of the storage spaces in here. Because there is something I want to do with it. And you'll see, I'll show you what I want to do. Okay, where's the nearest desk I can open? Can I open you? I can. Good. Oh, hey, there's bulk caps in there. All right, so we'll go to Misc. Oh, Misc. Got bars. Yes. Look how much that's worth. I'm not selling it. I am not selling a single bar of that. I don't want to. I already know what I'm planning to do with all this. Now, I'm still a little over encumbered because reasons. So hang on. Let me check my apparel because I've got this Sierra Madre armor, which is damage threshold of 18 for a weight of 17 versus damage threshold of 20 with a weight of 25. I may keep the Sierra Madre armor on for a bit because the Sierra Madre armor weighs less. I mean, it has less damage threshold, but it weighs significantly less. Until I find a replacement or something to fix my combat armor, which cost me a heck of a lot of caps, I want to point out. I feel like I should just use this one for now. Okay, so stick all the weapons I don't want to carry around with me. In fact, let me just... There we go. Oh, that's my main stuff. Okay, good. Now we're finally back at a more acceptable level. You can actually move. If you sell the gold, you can afford to fix your armor. That is probably very true. I don't want to sell the gold. I like storing it. Oh, I just realized, was I putting away something that didn't have any weight to it? I did. I put my venom away. Being a little overzealous with the clickies. Stuff. And a scotch we want to sell because I don't like to keep that. The stealth boys, the sugar bombs. I didn't pick up any beer, did I? I did a couple there. Sell that, sell that, sell that. Alright, that's good. That's a lot of sudden pre-war money. Okay, hang on, how many was it at a time? So it's 9, we can get, what is that, 14, ooh, okay. Nope, that's too much. That's a bit better, okay, so we need about 20, a little more. That's close enough. Good, that lands me a lot of caps. Right, now. Weapons, 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 weapons. Why do I still have anything else? Probably not. Right, okay, so what weapons am I gonna take? I had that one before because that was a very good laser rifle and I got a lot of ammo for it now, so we'll definitely take that back. I'm tempted to take this, but I don't have a lot of ammo for it. You know, even now that I'm back, I don't have a lot of ammo for it, so that wouldn't really do me a lot of good. A board machete is always a nice good whapper. That's explosive I don't need. Cosmic knife, no. Let's sell some of this stuff, but never mind. Definitely want to take the Gauss rifle. Definitely want to take that. Actually, I may not need the laser rifle anymore. Grenade rifle is always fun to play with. Hunting rifle, definitely. It's good for a distance thingamajiggy. Damage 14, DPS 43. Damage 19, DPS 31. So it is slower. It's also heavier, so no, yeah, I'll leave that. Alright, that's fine. Love and hate, don't need that. Maria. Oh wait, no, that's right. We don't want the grenade rifle, we want the mercenary's grenade rifle. Yeah, it's better. Um Okay, so that gives me, so we need 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Technically, we've got 5. We need some sort of pistol or... Is there any caravan shotgun? I can't remember what I was using beforehand. Wait, it's a thump thump. DPS. Damage 87. So 87, 37, and 87, 35. So technically, DPS is a little better. So again, swap it out for thump thump. Weather 10 milli. Good chunk of ammo for that. I can't remember what it was using before. Not enough sniper rifle ammo to justify that. I legitimately can't remember. It's been so long. It's been weeks. Was I using the service? I was using the service rifle as like my good sort of machine gun thing, wasn't I? So that gives me the 6. So if we have... Yeah, but we don't have... Hang on. That one we'll put back. We'll stick with the Gauss rifle because that's pretty good. It'll go down because it takes 5 per go, but we'll use it as a sniper for important stuff. So that's 7, 6. That's 1. That's 5. Do I want the service rifle? And then I need a shotgun of some kind. So I've got a single shotgun, which isn't very good. It's really caravan shotgun's a bit better. I think I was using that one. I think that was my shotgun, because I haven't found a decent, like a properly decent shotgun yet. Alright. Okay. Don't need that. Yeah, I think we're alright with that. I don't have a handgun, do I? I don't need a handgun. Do I need a handgun? The thing is, this is the thing. Because the 2 button is your swap things out, it basically means that you can only have 6, well, it's technically 7 if you include the 8th button, but I always have that for stimpaks, which should still be stimpaks. So if I got rid of that, what would I... I don't need a pistol. Do I need a pistol? Nah, I'll be alright. We got the hunting rifle. That'll be fine. Alright, so we can put those back into order. That there, you go onto that. You're there. You're there. No, you're there. You're there. You're there. Yes, Stimpax is already there. Excellent. Now we need to think of who the hell we can sell all that money to. Speaking of money, my plan for this is very simple. Where did I put it? Right here. Oh no, that's right. I need to dole it out. Very slowly. I can't pick it up, can I? Because it's like too... Is it too heavy to pick up? I think it's too heavy to pick up, isn't it? See, this is where toggling God Mode back on would be quite useful, actually. But basically, my plan... And I may do this, like, after the fact, because it would take me... It's going to take me, like, 20 minutes. If I just take one of those... This is my plan. Actually, I can take more than one, can't I? How heavy are they? Huh. Well, I can take 5. Well, that's nice, actually. Yeah, maybe it won't take so long. I'm gonna fill up this bathtub. That's my plan. You go to MISC. Doesn't always go in there, unfortunately. But that's something you can deal with. I think it's actually better if you do it one at a time. Don't that look good? Take another 5. Then you can literally just bathe in gold. Damn it. See, it's simple. Five at a time. And nice. You drop them on the floor, can you not lift them up with mouse? Nope. They're too heavy. Because they're made of gold. I'm pretty sure that's the case. Sure. Yeah. This is me trying to Z them up. No, it doesn't work. You can't pick them up. They're too heavy. Because it's a block of gold. Despite the fact that a block of gold is heavy but still liftable in real life, apparently not in this. I just want to fill my tub up with this stuff. Just so I can show off to people about how thoroughly rich I am. Not that long-winded a process, really. It's just a case of one thing at a time. Yeah, weird. Well, I mean, there are some things that you literally just cannot pick up, even if they're, like, collectible items. I guess it's just... it would speed the process up. Well, I guess. I mean, not like, massively. I mean, firstly, you have to drop them in groups of five anyway in order to separate them out. Because if you drop anything more than five, and... it all combines into one item. So you have to drop them in groups of five. But it's fine. Just so I can say I have a bathtub full of gold at home. Just so I can be, like, the richest guy in the Mojave. In fact, probably the richest guy in the whole of the New World. Let's be honest. I don't think anybody has this amount of gold. And there it is. A bathtub full of gold. I know that much. I encountered that when I was filling my bathtub with free war money. That assumes gold still is valuable. No, I don't assume that gold is still valuable. The game assumes gold is still valuable. Okay. Hang on a sec. So my next big thing is I need to find someone to sell all that stuff to. Honestly, that's the hard part. Like, who the hell am I going to sell all this pre-war money of mine to? I got a few ideas. There's plenty of sellers. The most expensive one is... Gunrunners. This could be a Rip Van Winkle caper. Use pre-war money as ammo for your junk shooter? I don't want to use it for ammo when I can sell it for caps. He's got 8,000. Besides, I don't use the junk firing thing. Pretty good. Ooh, very close. 56. One more. No, wait, can we get away with... No, we won't get away with one more. The Rip Van Winkle Caper was a Twilight Zone episode. Was it? I probably haven't seen it. In case you can't tell. Excellent. Isn't that just lovely? All those caps. And I already know what I'm going to spend them on. Alright, who else has got a bunch of caps? I'm trying to think who else has got the most caps. So much pre-war money here, it's ridiculous. Group of bandits makes off with thousands of dollars worth of gold bars. Escape the authorities, they hide in a cave of chemical gas, put themselves in stasis for 100 years. Ah, I think I see where this is going. And when they wake up, it's not worth anything anymore. Let's try the Mojave Outpost. Silver Rush has a lot of caps. That's true, it usually does.
Been doing a lot of good work out.
Oh yeah, that's right. He only repairs stuff. Where's the guy who sells? I think he's in the other place. Isn't he? He's in like the mess hall or something like that. Which is this building over here? Hopefully, anyway. Hello.
Background?
You got the trade. How much you got? Oh, you got 7,000. That's not too bad. And you finally got out the area. The hit is now a desert. They get lost, dehydrated, end up killing each other over the gold. The final survivor finally finds some people offering them gold, but he dies before they can do so. One of the comments, he offered this to me like it was worth something. Didn't they used to use gold for currency a long time ago? They did, before we found a way to manufacture it. Yeah, that makes sense. I mean, something only has value, A, if we give it value. No, that's way too much. And B, it's if it's rare. Something's rare, that usually gives it value. In theory. Close. Good enough.
Morning.
Morning. Is it? I suppose it is. You said the Silver Rush. Silver Rush. Anything that provides dopamine and rewards hedonism tends to have value. Also true. I suppose also difficulty in manufacturing. Although that kind of comes into like rarity. You know, if something's rare, it's, if something's difficult to manufacture, that makes it rare. So, you know, same difference really.
For all your energy weapon needs.
Just need another person with 8,000 caps. Hi, can I go in?
Afraid I'm gonna have to search you before letting you in.
Alright.
This should only... There. I've stole...
Thanks. Fucking stowing weapons.
The bosses are having a meeting. You'll have to wait until it's over.
Oh, yeah.
Mr. Soren, please get to the point. The second half of your payment is late, and I want to know why.
Miss Van Graaff, my associates and I have decided that we wish to renegotiate the terms of our deal.
Might I ask for what reason? The shipment was delivered. The guns were tested before leaving this facility.
Regardless, we feel that the quality of the weapons is below expectation and hope to adjust the price accordingly.
Ah, I think I understand what the issue here is. Excuse me for a moment, would you? Jean-Baptiste, could you bring out the volunteer?
A little quicker would be nice, please. I've got stuff to give you. You're not going to find it any use, but I will.
This is a lesson, Mr. Soren. A lesson in faith.
What is this, Miss Van Graaff? I don't understand. Who is this man? What does this have to do with our deal?
Everything. Up until recently, this man was an employee of mine. He's quite handsome, don't you think? I know I did. We became close. I warned him that I was a very jealous woman.
Hurry up.
He understood. Apparently, he didn't. Last week, I chanced upon him in Gamora, being serviced by one of their two-cab whores. I was not pleased. I tell you all this because I want you to know that this man means a great deal to me.
Mm-hmm.
Do it. Never break faith with the Van Graaffs, Mr. Soren. I expect you'll have the rest of our payment ready tomorrow morning. Okay, everyone. Show's over. Back to work.
I think you went. Get the fuck away from me.
Welcome to the Silver Rush.
What do you got for sale? What was that about having a lot of caps? 297? That's not a lot. I'd describe that as a little. Oh, I can give him a few at least. 1900.
You did make that part up, right, Glory?
Yay, I got my ship back again. Which means I gotta re-edit the sudden list. Okay. Who else is gonna have a lot of caps?
And the women are just like the boots.
Come to the Silver Rush for all your energy weapons.
That's cool. I wonder if they've still got money.
The needs.
Hello.
You're back.
What you got for sale? 2,400. Not as much as I was hoping for, but some. Endurance and the regen ability.
That's the Phoenix Monocyte Breeder. The implant speeds up cell regeneration, an effect similar to that of some lizards and sea creatures. The implant is very...
I think I can afford that.
Have a seat in...
Now I can, anyway. It's not like I got much else to spend the caps on. Hi.
You're back.
Can I have some of those caps back, please? No, I didn't think so. Too much to hope for. Can I buy an implant? Increase my endurance. Where's the caps?
Have a
Yeah. That's it. We're done. That's the 16,000. That's every implant in the game. I'm implanted up out my butt. So. And I still have 6,000 caps. And I've still got a whole bunch more left to sell yet. So. That's brilliant. I get some nice health regeneration out of it. It's not fantastic. It's a little more than... I don't actually know. Does it say how much health regeneration you get? I think it's like 2 points a minute or something like that. We're going to... Health implant. Perception implant. Strength implant. See, the subdermal armor one is so... Maybe I just missed over it. No, toughness. Didn't seem to be. That's strange. Unfortunate, but what are you going to do? I was kind of hoping it was sort of listed on here and I could look up exactly what it does. But I guess it's not a perk. I guess it's something else. But fine. Okay. Whatever. Alright, what time is it? It's 10 to 6. I was planning to do other things, but as always, the DLC took me so sodding long that... God, there is something I do actually need to check. I really hope I haven't already done this. If I'm lucky, I haven't. Because that will give me something to plan for next week. I'm trying to remember if I opened up this. It looked like it. No, I haven't. Brilliant. Haha. Yes. I couldn't remember if I'd done that or not, and I haven't, which is good. So that means, who the hell do I need to talk to start that quest? I have no fucking clue. I want to say it's the guys at Camp Searchlight. There's a quest you can do, eye for an eye. Leave the poor dog alone. Jeez Louise. Or dog up.
Honored to speak with you, ma'am.
Patrolling the Mojave almost makes you wish for a nuclear winter.
Trooper, where's the actual name guy? Is he out patrolling somewhere? This, I forgot how bad the bleeding what's it is on this. Where's the guy? Where's the name guy? He's in the tent, maybe he's asleep. Oh, that's just generic trooper. I see people.
You're back. What can I do for
you? The Legion camp at Cottonwood Cove.
The Rangers at Echo have been keeping an eye on that place. It's relatively new, but those bastards have already dug in. They appear to be running a slave trading operation, and it also seems to be one of the primary crossing points for Legion raiding parties.
Anything you need done?
If you could scout out the camp, bring back any intel on troop movement or plans for future raids. Also, if you're any good at covert ops, I would love to get a bug planted on their radio.
Hey there, have a lovely.
Good to hear. Report back.
All right. Should start. Yeah, I. Okay. So my plan for next week, seeing as we're clearly just out of time right now, I'm going to get Boone on side. and I'm gonna do his quests. His basically, in order to get Boone's quest active, you have to do certain actions with him in your group. Unfortunately, I've already done some of them, which is a bit sodding annoying. Because I forgot what it was, and I looked it up last night because I wanted to double check, because I knew I was gonna maybe do it today, but I've ended up running out of time. So I need to find Boone. I need to get him on side, and I need to do things. So you see, killing Caesar or killing his right hand man will get you points in favor of him. But I don't want to just... I do want to kill Caesar, don't get me wrong. But I don't want to be so direct about it. So opening the thing at Cottonwood Cove and killing everybody there, that gets you 2 points in favor of him. There's a point for talking to someone at Camp McCarran. And there was another 2 points I was looking at. I will double check the list and I will be able to do that next week. But what I'm going to do, last thing I'm going to do today, I've got to find the guy.
Welcome. Come on in.
Should be here. Boone, hello.
Yeah.
Hi, come with me. Let's go after the Legion.
You don't want to do...
We'll come over, two of us.
Yeah, that might be true. That's reason enough for me to take you up on it, I suppose. Fine.
All right. So yeah, we need to do a bunch of things with him in party. Like I said, do the eye for an eye quest. That'll get me 2 points. We've got talking to the guy at Camp McCarran and one or two other things. I can't for the life of me remember what the hell it was off the top of my head. Interestingly enough, you don't actually have to have him with you. Again, I looked this up. You can actually do it where he's like a partner, but you tell him to wait somewhere and he just stays there. So you can just go off and do whatever the hell you want. But yeah, we'll... So we've got Eye for an Eye active. We'll do that next time. I will probably just tell him to wait outside, otherwise he'll just start attacking the Legion idiots. So we'll see what happens next time, but that will be for next time, because as I said, I'm totally out of time for today. That why is it with things always seem to take me longer than I think they're going to? I must be like just rubbish budgeting my time or something like that. Thank you all for watching, everybody. I do hope you have enjoyed this, and I will see you all whenever I next see ya. Take care out there, everybody. Bye-bye.